a simple element, carbon C6-12. Okay, the underscript C6 is atomic number capital Z. The 12 superscript is atomic mass number capital A. Then atomic number is the number of electrons. How many electrons? 6 electrons are there. Right. Then atomic mass number. Mass number is the number of protons plus neutrons. Okay. And we know number of electrons is equal number of protons. So how many protons are there?
6
protons. So 6 protons are there. How many neutrons?
6
neutrons. Okay. So now we'll see. Just now I told you, molecule having spinning properties, though it will not give NMR spectra. So how it will not give NMR spectra? We'll see. Protons are 6, no? So in the nucleus, protons or neutrons are there, no? 3 protons spinning clockwise direction. Remaining 3 protons spinning anti-clockwise direction. Protons are over. What is the next one? Neutrons. In the neutrons, 3 neutrons spinning clockwise. Remaining 3 neutrons spinning anti-clockwise direction. Okay. The property of these 3 get cancelled by the property of these 3. What is the net result, ma?
Zero.
Either any spinning?
No.
But in general, spinning is there. I told you just now, I have a 5 molecule. 5 molecule having spinning property, though it will not give NMR spectra. Why it will not give NMR spectra? The net result is 0. Clockwise property cancelled by anti-clockwise. The clockwise property of the second one is cancelled by anti-clockwise of the second. Clockwise of the third one get cancelled by anti-clockwise. Like that. See. Here neutron. Clockwise of the first one get cancelled by the anti-clockwise of the second first one. Clockwise of the second one get cancelled by the anti-clockwise of the second one. Clockwise of the third one get cancelled by the anti-clockwise third one. What is the net result, ma? If there is no spinning, is there any spectra? Just now we have seen, no? NMR spectra is based on 3 factors. Radio frequency radiation, external magnetic field, nuclear spinning. Third factor, no? If no nuclear spinning, no spectra. Now you tell, is there any possibility of NMR spectra? Though nuclear under spinning. Though means, though there is a spinning of protons and neutrons. But here, the net result is 0. Net result is 0, thereby there is no spinning nucleus. Protons and neutrons are revolving only, but the net result is 0. Because of net result 0, there is no spinning. Thereby, there is no possibility of NMR spectra. Okay, I just compare this example with another example. With this, you may easily understand. C6-13, for example. C6-13, okay. What is 6? Number of electrons. Now you tell, in 13, how many protons are there?
6. 7 neutrons. 6 protons, 7 neutrons.
Right. Mass number is number of protons plus neutrons. Okay. Number of electrons always, equal to number of protons. So easily 6 protons. How many neutrons, ma? 7 neutrons. Okay. Is there any possibility for producing NMR spectra? How we'll see. 6 protons, no? 3 protons get clockwise. 3 protons get? What is the net result?
0.
This is proton. Coming to neutron. How many neutrons? Is there an equilibrium for neutrons?
No.
4 protons get clockwise. 3 protons anti-clockwise. These three. What is the net result? 1 extra, which is clockwise. If you take another one, 3 are clockwise, 4 are anti-clockwise. Okay. 3 get cancelled. What is the net result? 1 which is in anti-clockwise. Okay, nuclear spinning is there?
Yes.
Is there any possibility of NMR spectra?
Yes.
Then compare the second first one. First one, though the protons and neutrons under spinning, but the net result is 0. So there is no possibility of NMR spectra. That's why I'm saying few of the compound having nucleus, having the spinning of the protons and neutrons in the molecule, though it will not give NMR spectra, the reason is the net result is 0. So that's why I'm telling you, NMR is possible under 3 conditions. Presence of radio frequency radiation, the presence of external magnetic field, the final one is nuclear spinning. So here the information is the presence of, important one, the presence of either extra proton or extra neutron in turn causes spinning of the whole nucleus. Thereby it will give NMR spectra. But in the case, there is no presence of extra proton or extra neutron. Because of that reason, there is no spinning property, there is no NMR spectra. In this case, either extra proton or extra neutron is present. In this case, extra neutron is there. That extra neutron in turn causes spinning of whole nucleus. So spinning of whole nucleus, nothing but one condition is possible. So that will blindly will give NMR spectra. Okay, right. We have seen, I think, so many books. NMR also called as H1 NMR or proton NMR or PMR. So why NMR is also called H1 NMR or proton NMR or PMR or proton NMR? These three atoms. Okay. We know only one element in the nature which is having one proton without any neutron. The element is hydrogen. Okay, atomic number is 1. The number due to 1 electron, 1 proton. Is there any neutron? 0 neutron. So, blindly you can say, the proton either can spin in clockwise manner or anti-clockwise. What is the net result? Only 1 proton. Net result is only 1 proton. It may spin in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise. So, in any condition, even in the drastic condition also, it blindly give NMR spectra. No other element will give NMR spectra. Only NMR, only proton will give NMR spectra, because only one proton is there, either can spin in clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. So blindly it will give NMR spectra in any condition. That is the reason N superscript is nothing but only one proton is there, maybe clockwise, maybe anti-clockwise. Blindly it will give NMR. That is the reason H1 NMR proton. Here nuclear is nothing but one proton in the nucleus, no? That is the reason PMR, simply proton NMR. These three are the terms to indicate the things.